Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, your leaves are so unchanged.
Happy 1st of November! I hope you are enjoying this nice, cool weather. Today, I am sharing how I made this photo Christmas tree. Last year, I actually did something very similar with just pine sprigs, and since I really love working with photos during Christmas time, I wanted to make something more personalized, and this is how this Christmas tree came about. Here are the supplies I used to make it. Now, I'm not sure if you already know, but I always share my DIYs on the blog as well. If you want to check out more photos or more written instructions, I'll go ahead and add a link down below in the description. This Christmas tree is actually really easy to make. First off, I painted my wooden board white. Once it was dry, I measured and marked where I wanted my tree with a pencil. Then I lay a ruler next to where I marked the tree shape and marked dots an inch apart to help me know where I need to drill the holes. I chose to make my holes fairly tiny, and this actually made the project harder. You can make your holes bigger, it'll definitely speed up the project. Here's what all the holes look like once drilled. Now I used an eraser and erased all of my pencil markings. Okay, here's the toughest part of the project. If you made holes tiny like I did, you will need to use a needle and thread your yarn or embroidery thread through the needle each time, and this is how you'll attach your thread to the board. However, if you made holes big enough for a bobby pin to fit into the hole, this will speed up the process for sure. I threaded my embroidery thread through each hole, making sure to leave enough thread on both ends. Then I flipped the sign over and tied the thread on the back as tight as I could. I cut off any loose ends and kept repeating these steps to form a Christmas tree shape with the thread. Okay, here's how it looks all threaded. If you're going for a minimalist look, this would be super cute. Since I wanted to add photos, I went ahead and added the photos behind the yarn and added some pine sprigs. After adding the pine sprigs, my photos kind of were slipping out, so I added some double tape on the back of the photos and secured the photos to the board, and it worked perfect. That's all for this DIY. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope this inspired you to make your own personalized Christmas tree. Thank you so much for tuning in, everyone. Thank you so much for your love, your support, and thank you for helping my channel grow. I'll see you all next time. Bye!